beautiful people, welcome back. I hope everyone's having a beautiful day today. And in today's video, actually, you know, before we get into today's video, I just thought you should know, like, if you're a drugstore lover, I want to put it out there, make sure you are subscribed and you have your notifications on, because I believe, if I don't miss my guess, I believe every single video this week is actually drugstore content, because we have obviously today's video, we're getting into the new e.l.f. Mint collection, and along with that too, I'm going to update you on some of the other stuff, the putty blush, the CC cream, you know, just other stuff that I've tried in previous videos, which I'll make sure are linked up here. But then in addition to today's video, we also have my favorite drugstore makeup of 2020 and the another video testing out new drugstore makeup, because y'all, they just keep throwing it at me and I can't help myself, okay? I have to try all the new things. So we're going to be getting into, like I said, all the drugstore makeup this week. Make sure you are subscribed. Again, notifications are on because they go up, you know what? Hey, while we're here, they go up Monday, Wednesday, Friday, right around like 7:30 a.m. So we have bright early morning uploads. Again, all week we're talking about drugstore. But seriously, you guys, going into today's video, I can't even express to you the level of excitement I have. Like, this packaging, it just takes my breath away, okay? This is their little three-piece mint melt brush set. I thought this was so cute. I picked up that. Obviously, we have the primer. We have shadow sticks. We have these adorable little quads. And actually, you know what? While we're on the topic, I did unbox this over on Instagram. So if you don't follow me over there, make sure that you're doing that, because not only am I trying to hit 10,000 followers, and I would obviously greatly, greatly appreciate it, but it's also a really good place to get the behind the scenes. I put up a ton of makeup content. I do unboxing in my office. I ask you guys to do polls. You know, that way I kind of know what you're looking for in terms of content. And also in the feed too, I have a ton of other stuff, you know, obviously makeup related, inspo photos, mini tutorials, get ready with me, stuff like that. I also do plus size fashion, and I really just play around, I think, with all the, like, the other artsy things that don't exist here on YouTube for me. That's where I like to do them. So really, if you're looking for more of me, you want more content, you want to hang out in my day to day, check me out on Instagram. Also down in the description box, I will have several other things listed. Obviously all of this makeup, if you want to shop it, take a look. I'll have that all linked. I will have this outfit linked. It's all from ModCloth and it is so freaking cute. Not sponsored. I bought this myself, but I just think it is the most adorable thing ever. It's like this little skirt. It comes up here. You got the little turtleneck underneath. I'm obsessed. But I'll have this linked. I will also have, oh, my Amazon favorite storefronts. That will be linked down below if you want to see the things I love on Amazon. And then this one always makes me feel a little bit weird, but I always want to mention it because I still get questions on my P.O. box. And for those of you that don't know, or if you're newer here, I do now have a P.O. box. It is listed in the description box. It definitely took me a couple of years to get that far, but I just wanted to let everyone know it is there if you had something you want to send. You don't need to, but if you were just ever wondering if I had one, I do, and it's listed in the description box. But anyways, I think that that is it. No more housekeeping. Let's go ahead. Let's zoom the camera in and let's get started. Let's go ahead and get going into our first product. This is the e.l.f. Mint Melt Cooling Face Primer, which, boy, does that sound lovely, because, like, y'all, I am sweating right now. I'm having a really hot flash. I'm having a really hot flash. I'm having a really intense hot flash. I missed a word. All right, so what does it say here? This is actually a beautiful, I love the color of this so much. It says, need a cooling refresher? Bitch, yes, I do. This hydrating vanilla mint scented jelly primer is all you need. Its unique jelly texture works like a glue to grip makeup to ensure that it stays put. Its minty fresh skin loving ingredients will give you a refreshing cooling sensation. Infused with hyaluronic acid and antioxidants, bitch, we love a good hyaluronic acid moment. Your skin will be looking and feeling its very best. Okay, and then it says apply it to your face before makeup application and wait 30 seconds, which I typically do anyways. So let's go ahead. I just can't, oh my God, it's even got a pump. I love this packaging so much. So texture wise, this looks to be very similar to their pink Jelly Pop primer, which I actually really, really like. I'm gonna take and apply this one the same way I would that one. I like to concentrate it around my pores because these are the areas where obviously I am the most oily and where things break up the most. And I really like to kind of massage it and press it into those areas. And then I take the excess and kind of press it out on the outskirts right here over the cheeks. Okay, guys, so I'm not gonna lie. I'm like kind of really underwhelmed by the minty sensation they were talking about. I can't even smell it, okay? I just put a swatch of it on my hand to, like, get up close and really huff it in, and I can barely smell it, and it dissipates really quickly, which I'm not mad that it dissipates because I wouldn't want it to be something that, like, lingered all day. I think the fact that I can't smell it is actually giving way to why I can't, like, feel it on my skin. I'm not getting any of that, like, refreshing feeling they were talking about at all. It feels just like a regular primer. Didn't notice any, you know, overly refreshing tingly situation. As far as a primer goes, like if I look at it and I evaluate it just as a regular primer, I do like the way that it looks. I even notice on my hand where I just did a swatch of it, it does give a beautiful, like, smoothing effect to the pores and, like, my skin texture right there, which is nice. So I think for me, the most important claim with all of these would be the one that talks about how it's gonna help my makeup last and really grabbing on. And with that, I actually can feel a light tackiness to it. Like, it's nothing overwhelming. It's not like that weird sticky texture, because I don't really care for that. But I like that with this, there's a very light, again, just a light little tackiness on the skin. It's not overwhelming. It does have more of a smoothing kind of pore filling aspect. So those are good. But if you're in it for like that refreshing, you won't really like it. All right, now moving on, we're going to go into the e.l.f. Camo CC Cream. And this is a video that I did do like a full face testing it out. I'll link it up here. And I'm actually going to go through, I think I might have mentioned this at the start of the video, but I'm going to go through and use some other e.l.f. stuff. By the way, this is in the shade Fair 120N. But I'm going to go through and use some products from e.l.f. that I've used in previous videos and you take this time to give you a little bit of an update. That way you guys kind of know like my continued thoughts, if I've been wearing them, how I've been wearing them, stuff like that. So I will say with this one, starting off, be mindful of how much you apply because it does have a thicker consistency to it. And I find that on my textured, more acne prone skin, it does build up a little bit extra and it tends to be a little bit more aggressive when it builds up. Like it looks thicker and cakier faster, if that makes sense. And so with this one, what I like to do is go through and apply it, you know, just evenly all over the skin. I get about a medium coverage out of it, which I really like. I think the coverage is beautiful. Again, just making sure to stop when I hit that medium coverage. I know it can be, you know, tempting to want to build up like over the redness and stuff like that. But I find that because this has a thicker texture, I actually like to pair it with a thinner concealer. This is the Wet n Wild Mega Last Incognito Concealer, and it is in the shade Fair, which I did do a video testing this out as well, and I will link that up here. I did like a full-on drugstore video last week or the week before. So again, it'll be linked up here if you want some more info. But anyways, I think that with this one from e.l.f., this foundation CC cream stuff, it just layers a lot better the thinner that you go with it because it by itself is more susceptible to that thickness. So pairing it with other thinner items works better for me personally. So I'm just gonna say it. I know this is a first impression on that primer, but y'all, my skin looks so fantastic right through here, which is normally my troubled area. And I don't know if it's just a combination of all three of those things working great or what, but it looks so good. Even my nose looks great, which is like, that's kind of a cold day in hell. And it's just looking so wonderful. Okay, so because I'm gonna be going in a second and actually using the cream blush from e.l.f., I want to use a cream bronzer as well. And for the life of me, I cannot find. I was gonna use the one from ColourPop, that way it was still drugstore, but this is the only one that I have sitting out, so I'm gonna use it. It's from Charlotte Tilbury. This is the Hollywood Contour Wand. And I'm just gonna take a little bit of it here. I've actually been using this a lot lately. I pulled it out of my drawer. I'm just obsessed with this. I love the texture. It's so easy to use. Blends like a freaking dream. I'm gonna go in here with a BH number 2. It's just an older little fluffy brush that I got in a kit. Because I just love the profile of it. It works perfect for this application. All right, so with the sculpting done, we're going to move on to an update on the e.l.f. Putty Blush. And it does not say anywhere on this, there's not like a sticker to tell me what shade this is. So I will have that link down below. But I still wanted to give you guys an update on this. I freaking love this little rosy pink color. And then for application, I'm actually using the e.l.f. Putty Primer Applicator. I really, really like the poofiness and the stoutness of this brush for the blush. Even though obviously the one end, oh my God, look at that. Look at that color. Even though the one end does have the scoop, like it's obviously made for the primer, but I just love the way that it applies the blush. I think it's so cute and it really does do a nice job at like pressing the color in. Oh God, I'm gonna take the excess too and pop that up on my temples. So with this on and applied, I think the number one thing, sorry, I got distracted. Okay, my mom just brought me in a Diet Coke with light ice and oh my God. It is delicious. Getting into the blush, I really feel like as far as the stuff that e.l.f. has come out with, I think this is one of their absolute best products, not only in terms of like the consistency and the way that it presses in, like the actual usability of this product is fantastic. You can build it up, you can sheer it out, all of that's great. But I think most importantly, something that I look for in a product like this is the texture and the way that it kind of builds up as far as like the thickness goes, kind of what I was talking about with the CC cream. Like I don't want things to look super thick and cakey and heavy. And with this one from e.l.f., I just really, really appreciate that it's not like that at all. It's very, very thin in texture, but you still are able to get a workable color, something, again, you can build up, you can sheer it out, do whatever. And I've just found a lot of use with this, even as somebody that like layers up, obviously, you know, you guys know this or you might not if you're new, but I'm a big powder person. I have to have powder. I have combo leaning oily skin. And even as somebody, again, that does build that up and I put copious amounts sometimes of powder on my skin, I still feel like this is thin enough that I can put that powder on top and it never mixes or looks looks thick or chunky, and the texture of it's just never an issue. Like, the color's always there, and I am just freaking obsessed. And then just for fun here, I'm gonna go in with some of the e.l.f. Jelly Highlighter. This is in the shade Bubbly, and I'm just gonna lightly tap some of it here and then sheer it out. This one for me, I'm not a huge fan, I will say, of like jelly products like this, because typically on my skin, they don't really work that well. I feel like more often than not, the highlighters tend to fight my powders and like the layers that come obviously after the cream products. But the downside with this one is that it's kind of catch-22 actually, because the texture is very, very thin, which is good because it doesn't bother my foundation that I already have down, but it also doesn't get in the way of my powders, which I really like that. But then the downside to that, I mean, you guys can kind of see it, no matter how much I apply, no matter how I try to build this product up, because it's so thin, it does tend to kind of recede into my foundation. And instead of getting like that super beautiful, you know, really intense sheen, can you even see that? I put it in like the worst possible spot. But instead of getting like this really beautiful sheen like I originally had when I laid it down, it does tend to just kind of settle out, and instead you're left with a nice little glow, which again, there's nothing wrong with a glow, but if you're going for that intense look on your skin, like what you get when you first are playing with it, I don't know that this is gonna be the one for you. Like right here in real life, I mean, I know on camera you can see like a little bit, like a little lilt, but in real life you literally can't hardly see it. It's just a light. It looks like the light is hitting me, and it's my natural skin. It doesn't look like it's really glowing much. So in terms of this product, I think, you know, unless you're going for that super duper natural type situation, I just don't think that you're gonna get that overwhelming, you know, jelly pop glowy situation that you're looking for, at least not in my experience. All right, so for the next couple of steps, I'm actually just gonna fast forward through them, and because I don't have anything e.l.f. wise that I need to catch up on. So I am gonna take the One Size Setting Powder. This is from Patrick Starr's brand, and I'm gonna take this under the eyes and through the T-zone. And then after that, I'm gonna take the Fenty Pro Filter Soft Matte Powder Foundation in the shade 150, and I'm gonna use that to lightly set the rest of the face, and then we will get into brows. All right, now while I was off of camera too, I didn't have anything for a bronzer from e.l.f. that I needed to update, so I just used the matte bronzer from Essence. This is their Sun Club matte bronzer. And then that's gonna lead us right into another one that I used on camera, I don't remember how long ago now, it's probably been a month or 2 months ago, but this is the newer from e.l.f., their Bite Size Face Duos, and I have them in Cantaloupe and Watermelon. I'm actually gonna use the Watermelon one today for my blush. I'm gonna mix the matte side and the shimmer together lightly. I don't want a ton of shimmer, but I just want a little bit for like that glowy little cheek moment. I'm gonna take and just lightly pop that on here. As far as these little bite-sized duos go, I actually really, really like them. I think that the texture is beautiful. They press into the skin fantastically. And where's my spray? Hello? And I'm gonna go ahead, sorry, it was on the ground, which is obviously where everybody keeps their sprays. But I'm gonna go ahead first here really quick and use a little bit of the Catrice Prime and Fine Dewy Glow Setting Spray. Just because I like to lay down a little bit of setting spray, really press my layers together before I go in with highlight, which for that I'm actually going to use their Bite Size Face Palette in Cantaloupe, this shade right here by itself, and I'm just going to apply it with my Scott Barnes 66, which you guys know, oh my god, look at how beautiful that is. I love this color. You guys know, if you followed me since the beginning of the year, I have just been on a Scott Barnes brush kick, and I don't know what happened. I fell away for a minute, and now I'm back, and I am just full on obsessed with this brush. I think it's so beautiful. The texture is amazing. All right, now next up is brows, and I'm gonna do this primarily off camera because I have talked about this so much on camera, but this is the e.l.f. Brow Wow Brow Gel, and I have it in the shade Brunette. I've fallen madly in love with this brow gel, okay? I think it is so, so good. So I'm gonna take this, spoolie it through the brows, get them nice and floofy, and then from there, I'm gonna go in and fill in the sparse areas with the NYX Lift and Snatch Brow Tint Pen. This is also in the shade Brunette. All right, you guys, so with the brows done, now it's time to get into eyeshadow, and I do have obviously both of the palettes here. We have the All Mint one, which is the Mint to Be, and then the other one here, which is the Chocolate Mint, and I did go ahead and swatch both, and I gotta say, as far as these swatches go, they feel very nice. The ones in the Mint palette right here, those two shimmers do tend to feel a little bit more thick, a little more glittery than the ones out of this one, but I think, you know, even looking at them, they also have a little bit more of that glitter kind of particle texture, so I'm not mad at it. I'm not surprised. I gotta say too, I think like in terms of finding a concept and running with it, I was actually really happy the way that e.l.f. did this, because even if you have one, the other, or both of these, I think that you really could create a lot of really beautiful eye looks with it. And then also in addition to that, I didn't swatch these ones yet. These are the Mint Melt No Budge Shadow Sticks, and I thought we would go ahead and swatch these real quick here. How do I want to do this? Where are you gonna? Well, you know what? We'll swatch them right here. So the first one we have up here, this is the darkest one. It's in the shade Melt With Me. It's a dark brown with gold shimmer. Then right under underneath of that. Oh, that's gorgeous. It's like a seafoam green. That one right there is the shade Mint For You. Oh my, that would make a beautiful lower liner type situation, like right on the waterline. Oh my God, that is such a gorgeous shade. Very, very creamy. And last but not least, I don't know how well this one's gonna show up on camera. It's like a light kind of champagne shimmer shade. This is the shade Ice Cream. And oh my God, like all three of those together are so gorgeous. Again, very cohesive even with the palettes. Oh God, this is gonna be so much fun. I think I'm gonna get started just by priming the lids with a little bit of that same Incognito concealer really quickly. And let's not forget too, going into this, because I almost did, we have the brush collection here. It's a three-piece brush set. And I think I'm gonna start off, oh, I love these profiles actually. I'm gonna start off with the fluffier one right here. This is the blending brush. And I think I'm just gonna go in with a nice neutral base here, get everything started with this brow. Actually, you know what? No, I lied. I'm gonna go in with this one right here, the light, very, very light, actually, mint green. I'm gonna start with this one right here in the inner area because I wanna see if it's actually a shade that you can build up to get some payoff, or if it's more so just gonna, you know, like set the lid down. Is there any actual like power, any pigment behind this? And you know what? That's actually a really beautiful light shade. It's definitely not, you know, not gonna build up and be super intense in the color, but I like the fact that it's just a nice little light wash. That's actually really pretty. Okay, so I was a little bit apprehensive going into that shade that I wasn't gonna love it because I just didn't think I was gonna get any like of that true tone out of it. But I actually really, really like this color. I think, again, it builds up beautifully. And I like the fact that it kind of adds like a fun little pop of color, because next up, I'm actually gonna go in with this light brown shade right here, this caramely brown. And I'm gonna take that same brush, just kind of dust it off a little bit. And I'm gonna pop this shade more so on the outer V right here, and use it to very lightly kind of blend it up and fluff it into that that other shade we just put into the crease, because I think the blending of those two together is actually gonna look super beautiful. So I think I'm gonna leave the depth right about there. I want it to stay more on like the fun, light kind of vibrant side. And I know if I keep adding the brown, I'm just gonna really deepen it up and make it way darker than I want to. And I think from there, I really am drawn to this green shimmer right here, like on the inner corner. Like I just, oh my God, look at how fun that shade is, you guys. Okay, so I just had a really good idea. I think I'm gonna start incorporating actually this shadow stick. I know I just said that I don't wanna go too dark and I still don't, but I want to take just for a little bit of depth, okay? I'm gonna take the shadow stick in the shade Melt With Me, the dark brown, and I wanna put that a little bit on the outer V, and then take this shimmer right here, the one out of the All Mint palette, and I'm gonna pop that from the inner corner and kind of blend it all the way over the rest of the lid. I think that that combination is gonna be gorgeous. All right, so with that on, first of all, I want to say I love the combination of those two shades. I think it is absolutely beautiful. And I want to take this same shadow stick really quickly here and very lightly kind of run it on the outer portion of my lower lash line and then just blend it out with my finger. I just want to add a little bit more depth. And then I'm also gonna go into here with the Ice Cream shade, that light shimmer. And I wanna use that on the rest of the lower lash line and also into the inner corner. And then just a little bit over top of that, I'm taking the shade Cantaloupe out of that face palette, the one I used to highlight my whole face. And I'm just using that just as a little bit of extra dimension. And then lightly kind of dragging that onto the lower lash line. Oh my God, that looks so pretty. And I did mention earlier wanting to take this Mint For You, the mint green shadow stick here, and putting that on my lower lash line. And I still think I'm gonna do that, or on the waterline right there. But I am gonna wait until after I do my mascara and all of that. Otherwise, I'll end up getting this covered in 100 other colors anyways. Before I finish up the eyes, I wanna finish up the rest of the face as well. So I'm gonna go in with a couple sprays of the Stay All Night Microfine Setting Mist from e.l.f. Give it a good little shake here. Now I will say with that setting spray, I haven't used it enough to really solidify if I think it makes your makeup last longer or not, but I do really appreciate the mister on that. I like that it's a nice, you know, fine application if you're someone that doesn't like that really intense, you know, garden hosey kind of spray. That's actually a good micro mist. And then really quick too, I'm going in with a little bit of the e.l.f. Halo Glow Setting Powder, and this I have also talked about at length at this point, but I really enjoy it just as a nice final step just to, you know, go through, really refine my skin. It looks so, so beautiful, especially over like this whole region right here. And also, as far as what I'm using to apply it, this is an older Wayne Goss brush. I don't even know if this is still a brush that he makes or not, because it doesn't have a number or anything on it, but it's just a super light, very flimsy, airy kind of brush, and I love it for this step. Now I'm gonna go ahead and finish up the eyes with some mascara here. This is the e.l.f. Lash It Loud Volumizing Mascara, and I'm gonna go ahead, curl up the lashes, apply a couple of coats of this. All right, so obviously I went ahead, built up the lashes, and And I did go ahead and put this mint shade on my lower waterline. And I just want to say, first of all, very, very creamy. Like, it just glided right on there. I don't know how well it's going to stay, obviously, given that I put it on my waterline. But it looks really, really beautiful. And I also wanted to give a little bit of an update, too, on the mascara, because obviously it's marketed as a Lash It Loud volumizing mascara. And for myself personally, I don't really find this to be a super volumizing mascara. I find it to be one that is more individualizing, very lengthening, actually. It does a great job separating and all of that, but I don't think it's great as far as the volumizing side goes. So it's not that I don't like it. I've actually used it quite a few times. It's just, again, be in mind as far as the marketing side goes, it's not very volumizing, at least not in my opinion. And then the other thing I wanted to say too with this is be mindful, because the spikes on it, like the actual bristles, are very, very, very spiky, like very rubbery, extra pointy, and they will gouge your damn eyeballs out. So just be extra careful with it. But other than that, I haven't had any issues. I think it builds up nice. Again, gives me good length. They're nice and black. I love that. Now, finally, last but not least, we are going to get into these glosses from the Mint collection. I did pick up all four shades. Obviously, as you can see, we have two that are more of the opaque type. We have a clear one and then a sparkly clear one. So let's go ahead and swatch these out in order. This is, oh God, this one is probably my favorite. Oh yes, I love a brown gloss. I just think they're so beautiful. They're super easy to wear. This one is in the shade Chocolate Chip. Oh my God, are you gorgeous? And next up here, we have the shade Mint Chocolate, right? Is that right? Yeah, Mint Chocolate. It's more of like a pinky nude shade. All right, now underneath of that is the shade A Hint of Mint. And this one, I think it's more of a clear gloss, but it does, like looking at it in the tube, it does have a very slight green tint. Again, coming off in swatch, it's definitely more of just like a straight up clear gloss. Okay, and then certainly last but not least, that is gorgeous. I don't know if it shows up much different on camera than the one above it, but this is the Glittery in Mint Sparkle, and I really, really love that color. Like, if you were to use this just to top like a fun, you know, kind of lip look or something, this is super beautiful. Now, of course, y'all know me. I'm going to go in with the darkest shade. This is, again, Chocolate Chip, the one up on top. But before I do that, I am going to line my lips with a little bit of the Teddy shade from M Cosmetics. This is their Velvet Blur Lip Liner. So with that on, let's go ahead now and apply the gloss. I'm just gonna do, oh yes, honey. A nice little thin coating. And you know what? Actually, just for a little bit of extra pizzazzle, I'm gonna take some of the sparkly gloss and just kind of throw it on the center of that, just because why not? Ooh, that's fun. That's super fun. Definitely make sure, though, if you do something like that, wipe off the wand before you stick it back in the container. Oh, that's fun. It just adds like a little extra pop. This is actually really pretty. But all right, you guys, with that, obviously the full face is done and complete. And I'm going to go ahead and start off by giving you the up close. That way you can see how everything came together, because I am freaking obsessed with this. I think it looks so good. I love the combination of the mint and the brown on the eyes. I love that fun little light waterline moment from the that No Budge shadow stick. I think that looks beautiful. The lips look amazing. As far as the complexion goes, you guys, I am obsessed with the way my skin looks. It's just so effortlessly kind of pressed in, very, very seamless, super smooth. And I don't even have one bad thing I can say. Like, not, there's not one negative comment about anything that I tested today. I think everything came together so nicely. Now, one thing I wanted to mention with these glosses is that they are a lip plumping gloss. So they do have a little bit of that, you know, light tingly sensation. It's not anything overwhelming. Truthfully, I didn't even really notice it for like the first probably minute and a half it was on, because it's just a very, very light sensation, but still something to mention. Just in terms of, you know, if you're sensitive to that. Now, I will say, out of all these products, the one that I really don't have any definitive thoughts on yet is obviously the primer, because it was a first impression. But just given how beautiful my skin looks right now, like, I'm definitely not mad at it. I will keep testing it out, let you guys know, of course, you know, how it ends up working for me in like a later video. But again, I don't have any issues with anything I tested. I love the eye look, and I love to, and you can let me know down below, do you guys like these kind of videos? Because I love getting to go through and giving you, you know, obviously new things that have launched and we can talk about new, but I also really love getting to give the updates and keeping you guys informed on stuff that I've already purchased. So again, please let me know down below, what do you guys think of the style of video, the products, anything like that. Give me all of your thoughts down below. And then, of course, like I said at the start of the video, everything I used today will be linked down below. You can subscribe, turn on your post notifications, follow me on Instagram, which of course would be greatly appreciated. And you guys, I don't think I have anything else. Thank you all so much for watching. I really appreciate it. And I hope you all have an amazing day, night, weekend, whatever it is when you're watching this, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye. All right, now moving on from here, I'm actually going to use the It Cosmetics. No, I'm not. This is how you spell It Cosmetics? With an E-L-F? Okay. Ding, ding, bing, ding, 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 bing. Unless you're after that. Okay. But this one, I can feel the gripping effect, which I think out of all the claims. Whoops.